Namaste to all. Probably many of you would have heard about Katha Upanishad, discussion between Yamaraj and Nachiketa. In this short audio, we will understand the key qualities of an aspirant. Aspirant is a person who is in search of truth, basically. What are his qualities that we can learn from Nachiketa, from Katha Upanishad? I will try to make the audio very short, but it's very important for us to have these qualities inside us if we are in search of truth. To start with, Nachiketa is a young boy and he is seeing his father. His father is also a learned Acharya of Vedas, but his father, after doing the Yajna, his father is donating cows to the Brahmins. Brahmins are not by caste system. Brahmins are those people who are learned Acharya of Vedas, and giving donation to Brahmin is a Vedic culture, Vedic tradition. So Nachiketa is carefully observing his father, that his father is donating those cows which do not yield any milk and those cows which are not healthy in nature, and his father is preserving those cows which are yielding lot of milk and as well as which are very healthy to himself. So Nachiketa is thinking and wondering, why my father is doing like this? And if he is not donating the right cows to the learned Brahmins, he will not get any blessing from them. He will get, in fact, curse. So he gets little bit worried about his father, and he thinks that probably my father is not donating these cows which are good, because he is worried about my future, and probably if I am dead or if I am going out of this house, then these cows also will be donated by my father to those Brahmins, and thereby he will get the blessings of both the Acharyas as well as the Almighty God. So in an attempt to endure this, that his father does like this, he goes to his father and says that you are now donating all your assets, etc. Now you tell me to whom you are going to donate me. His father silently watches, and then he will ignore him. Again and again, Nachiketa puts forward the same question. Tell me, father, to whom you are going to donate me? Tell me, father, to whom you are going to donate me? Then out of irritation, his father gets angry, and then he says that I am going to donate to you to death. Go and die. So he will be very angry and he will give a curse that, and go and die, I am going to donate you to death. Then Nachiketa thinks little bit, he becomes happy inside himself, and then he will go out of the house, and his father will think that probably Nachiketa is dead and he is no more alive. So Nachiketa, actually he will not die or he will not do suicide. He will go to the Acharya of Yamaraj. Yamaraj is the name of an Acharya who has won over the death by realizing the Almighty God. So normally any person who becomes a yogi, he is also normally termed as Yamacharya Yamaraj, because he is controlling death. He does not need to take another birth, and then he will never die again. That is why Acharyas are called as Yamacharya. So he goes to the Yamacharya. And he finds that Yamacharya is not in his house, and then he will wait outside the Yamacharya's house day and night for 3 days and three nights without having any food, without having any water, etc. He will wait for the Acharya to return to his home. After 3 days, when Acharya comes to his house, he finds Nachiketa there, and then he learns that Nachiketa did not had any food and water for last 3 days and has been waiting for Yamacharya. So Yamacharya gets very much pleased with this kind of gesture of Nachiketa, that he is such an aspirant that he is not even having his food, but he wants to see me. That is his priority. So here we have to learn a very, very key quality of an aspirant, that an aspirant should not desire even food. An aspirant should always desire knowledge only. This is what my Acharya has taught to us. Of course, I am not an eligible person to say like this, but still, it's probably one of you who is listening this audio is probably eligible and who has this kind of quality within you and which may support you. That's why I'm just sharing with you. So an aspirant aim is not in food and water or any other enjoyments. An aspirant is always having a quest to see his Acharya and learn from his Acharya only. Even my Acharya, when he shared his story on how he met his Guruji in his jungle, in a dense forest, he always says that I have never worried about my food or how will I get water, or where will I stay, etc. Whenever I visit my Acharya in the forest. In fact, my Acharya says his Guruji has never even offered him even like blankets, etc. to sleep. because his Guruji always used to live alone, and then he does not have any facilities. And his Guruji always tells that if you want knowledge, you come here, but I will not give you blanket, and you cannot bring blanket etc. from your house. I will give you a gunny bag, and you have to sit in this and do tapasya, and you have to sleep in the same gunny bag without any blankets, even at minus 10, minus 20 degrees in those days. So my Acharya always says this is one of the key quality of an aspirant to gain knowledge. If you are having the thirst to gain knowledge, thirst to gain Brahma Vidya and Yoga Vidya and Veda Vidya, you should never worry about food and water, etc. Of course, you will get it, but then you should not worry about it. You should always worry about when I will meet my Acharya and when I can learn my knowledge. So with this kind of gesture, a young boy is standing outside the house for 3 days without food and water. Yamacharya will be pleased, and Yamacharya will say that since you are staying here for 3 days and three nights, I will give you three boons. You can ask any boon, I will give you and grant you for that. So you can ask me. So Nachiketa says these three boons are very, very important for us to learn that an aspirant should be of this kind of quality and attitude and character. The first boon Nachiketa asks him is, I have left my home. My father is probably thinking that I am dead, and probably my father is sad or in anxiety or in depression, and probably he is not even getting proper sleep in the night times. So Yamacharya ji, I request you to grant a boon that my father will sleep peacefully at night. My father will realize in his heart that I am still alive, and my father has to realize that I am very safe. And also my father has to recognize me after whenever I return from here to my house after finishing my education with you. My father should recognize me and then accept me as his son. So I want this boon from you, Yamacharya. This is what Nachiketa will ask. And of course, Yamacharya will be very much pleased with this kind of gesture from Nachiketa, and he will grant this boon. So here we have to learn that the first quality, this is a Vedic knowledge, this is a great secret in Vedas also, that before learning Vedas, before going to an Acharya to serve an Acharya, you have to worry about your parents. You have to serve your parents, Mata Pita. That is, your mother and father should be pleased with you. Without they are pleased with you, you will never be able to attain any knowledge from an Acharya. And this is the knowledge also my Acharya always tells us, that before, if you are coming to me to learn Vedas, but if you are not serving your parents at home, you will not be able to understand anything what I teach you. So this is a great quality of Nachiketa which we have to learn, and Yamacharya will give the boon, and then he will say that your father will sleep peacefully at night, don't worry, and he will also recognize you once you go back, and he will also know that you are not dead. He will know inside his heart that you are alive still. So the second boon, Nachiketa will ask that I want to learn from you the Agni Vidya. Agni Vidya, in today's common term or in Vedic term, we can say as Agni Hotra and Yajna, the process of how to do and what are the mantras to chant, what is the benefit of Agni Hotra, all those secrets are part of Agni Vidya. So you will ask Yamacharya, I want to know Agni Vidya because I know that without having knowledge of Agni Vidya, one can never attain Swarga. Swarga does not mean a place in a space which is a planet which has a lot of food, water and beautiful girls dancing, etc. This is not correct. Swarga means it's a place, it's our own house where we feel happiness inside us and we peacefully sleep at night and we have every wealth possible with us. That is called a Swarga. So Yamacharya will be pleased with this again, and Yamacharya will give this boon and also will teach him how to construct a Vedi, that is a Havan Kunda, how to do, what mantras to chant for Agnihotra, what is the necessity for Agnihotra, how to worship Almighty God, what are the names of God in Agnihotra, all those secrets Yamacharya will teach him, and this is a Vedic Diksha actually. So here also we have to learn that our main aim as an aspirant is to search for an Acharya to get a Diksha and then understand the Agni Vidya, because without Agni Vidya we cannot be a Paropakari, we cannot be able to do good to the society, because once we do Agnihotra, this whole world is benefited by our Agnihotra. So Yamacharya will teach the Agni Vidya in detail, and Nachiketa will be very much pleased and happy by learning this knowledge. And then later on, Yamacharya will ask, now you asked for the third boon. So now Nachiketa will ask the third boon that there are many people, many learned people also have this doubt that what happens to soul after death. Many people have a doubt that whether soul exists or not. What happens to the person once he dies? Is there a soul or not? What then, if there is no soul, then what leaves the body? If there is a soul, then what happens after death? These kind of questions he will start asking, and this is what is my third boon. Nachiketa will ask Yamacharya. Then Yamacharya will say, will be a little bit surprised that why he is asking this kind of deep secrets, because this secret is revealed only to an aspirant who is really wanting to know about Almighty God and self-realization. So I will not be able to give this knowledge to Nachiketa. So he will think in his mind, and then he will ask Nachiketa that, Nachiketa, I will not be able to give this knowledge to you or grant this boon to you. You can ask me any other boon. I have already promised you that I will give you 3 boons, but I have given you 2 only, and this third one unfortunately I cannot tell you. So you ask for any other boon, I am fine. In fact, Yamacharya will say that you ask for hundreds and thousands of years of your life, you ask for many grandchildren or children, so many beautiful sons and daughters you will get in your life, and further there your son and daughters will get so many sons and daughters, everyone will have so much of wealth, everyone will have all the wealth possible in this world. Even if you want the wealth of the whole world, I am ready to give you anything what you want in this universe, but don't ask me this secret about a soul, whether soul exists or not, or what happens after death. In fact, here Yamacharya also says that etat tulyam yadi manyase varam vrinishva vittam chirajivikam cha. Chirajivi means long life, healthy life, wealthy life. These are all not the boons which any normal person will get. Every person is longing for these kind of boons, Nachiketa. You ask this kind of boons, I am ready to grant you. In fact, these are durlabha. You use the word, these are not possible to get also in human life. I am ready to give you all the possible worldly enjoyments. In fact, it is also equivalent to the boon which you are asking only. So Yamacharya is trying to divert Nachiketa that, okay, this is also equal to the secret of death. So you enjoy worldly pleasure. Why you are bothered about what happens after death? I don't think you need this kind of knowledge. Then Nachiketa will reply that, Sarvendriyanam jarayanti tejah shobhava martayasya yadantakaitat. So he says, Acharya, actually even if you give me hundreds and thousands of years, even if you give me all the wealth possible in this universe, so many golds and diamonds and properties and house and flats, whatever it is, even if you give me, this is only there, and also beautiful wife and big family, etc. These are all there only to take the vitality of my senses. And how long I can live? At one point of time, I have to die. I have to leave this body because death is for sure certain. And also, please, Acharya, understand, na vittena tarpaniyo manushyo. There is no human being who gets satisfied with vittena means with the wealth, with the money, with the assets. This can never satisfy any human being, and this will never satisfy me, Acharya. So I really do not want this. So you only keep these boons which you are granting me. I don't want this. And in fact, I am not worried about money. I am not worried about wealth. Having seen you, having got your darshans, I am very sure that I will get all these things in my life, because I will be doing Agnihotra. I got your Diksha. I got your blessings. I will be worshipping Almighty God. I will never become poor. That I am very much aware. But I don't want these boons. I want the boon, the secret of what happens after death. Whether the soul exists or not. If the soul exists, what is that soul? I want this knowledge, Acharya. Now seeing Nachiketa so much firm, Yamacharya will be very much pleased. And then he will then start giving the knowledge about soul. He will then start giving the knowledge about Jivatma, Paramatma, all those knowledge, Brahma Vidya, secret of Vedas, the name of Almighty God as Om, all those things which I have already made several videos in my YouTube channel. So, but I'm not going to discuss that. But here we have to understand the third important quality of an aspirant is not materialistic needs. Materialistic needs will anyway come when we follow the Vedas. Materialistic desires will be fulfilled by Almighty God's blessings and Acharya's blessings anyways. But if we desire materialistic needs only, then we will never be able to get Brahma Vidya. We will never be able to understand the secret of our life and death. So this has to be very much understood by us so that we can try to adopt the quality of Nachiketa, which is very, very difficult. My Acharya always says that I have never seen any of my disciples having this kind of desires in you. My Acharya says, I have never come across any aspirant in my life who has this kind of desires like Nachiketa. In fact, my Acharya says, even seeing an aspirant like Nachiketa is a pious deed. There is no one in this world, there is, who is equivalent to Nachiketa, who is an aspirant who wants Brahma Vidya only and not any other materialistic benefits. So this is the third important quality, that we have to fix our life's goal. Because here Nachiketa says, Navittena Tarpaniya Manushya. Human beings can never get satisfied with materialistic gains, materialistic benefits. Human beings will get satisfied only by knowing the secret of soul and secret of Paramatma, which is in vast described in the all the four Vedas. In fact, it is not described in Upanishad. It is not described in vast in Kathopanishad also. Kathopanishad gives a lot of hints, of course. It says your human body is like a chariot. You are a soul and your soul is connected to the chariot of human body by the five senses. These five senses are like the horses and you are the owner of the chariot. You are sitting in the chariot and your buddhi, intellect, is the driver who is driving the chariot, and the rope is controlling the horses, which is your mind. These kind of beautiful example the Rishi Yamacharya gives to Nachiketa to explain what is, how our human body functions. If we are controlling the mind, if we are controlling the rope, the horses will forward in the right direction. If you are not controlling the rope, that is the mind, then the horses will be always attracted towards the materialistic benefits and it will lose its aim of the life, which is ultimate going to Brahma Loka, that is attaining the self-realization and attaining the Almighty God's realization. So these kind of secrets are really mentioned, not in depth, but these kind of secrets are there in Kathopanishad. But please understand, Upanishad, Shad means Vedas, truth. Shad means Satya, truth. Truth are Vedas. Upanishad means going towards the lotus feet of Acharya to listen Vedas. That is called as Upanishad. So Upanishad gives the knowledge of Vedas. So today also, if we have to understand this kind of secrets, we have to go and search an Acharya of Vedas. These are the three qualities, very, very important character of an aspirant. Number one, serving the parents and worrying for the parents. Number two, learning Agnihotra, doing Agnihotra. Number three, aiming for the Brahma Vidya, always aiming for the Brahma Vidya and Yoga Vidya. I hope you got a little bit of knowledge from this audio video. I request you to listen it again and also spread it to other people. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om.